this is Keith from Speak and Spell. The band have recently decided to put some videos out to show how we do some production, just to give people who are into synths and whatnot a little bit of an idea about how we go about it. First off, let me apologise for my headphones. I only got these on because I don't actually know too much about this screencast business. Never done it before. First go, really. I've had a few run-throughs, but I don't actually know how to wire it up without these on. And also, I'm looking at a screen over here, but I know you're there, so hopefully not being too rude by constantly looking away. As you'll see, we're going to see you here. And when we produce a track, we refer to literally everything that we can get our hands on. 7 inches, 12 inches, album tracks, remixes, 5.1s, live performances, to try and find out quite what Depeche did. Because whenever it's bundled in together, it's quite difficult to hear various bits. So we refer to what we can. You know, if we can pick up a snare or a kick or an effect, you know, that's a signature sound, we will. Of course, we prefer to resynthesize things or pick out an original emulator or Emacs library or whatever it was. And of course, now with the advent of the new Synclavia software that we've got via VCollection 5, we can get access to an awful lot sort of more than we had before. So with See You, of course, everybody knows the track from that bass line, which is absolutely killer sort of bass line, which we've put together from the start of this, and just give ourselves some time here, with a synth sound. Now, hopefully I should be able to play a little picture-in-picture thing in one of these corners, maybe up there, of the bass line playing, not actually using it, playing it on a proper synth. The synthesizer that's producing it is a software synthesizer called an Arturia SEM, and you'll see the sequencer start to play it very shortly now. Right, okay, well, here's the sequencer playing it, and you'll see it's just some of the notes triggering down here, and it's this soft synth here. It's a remake of something that was around in the 70s. You can still get the versions of it now, but we think we've got pretty close to with that. In truth, there are three of those sounds pulling that together. In addition to that, we've got some other pieces happening with some synth sounds that that's something called EXS24, and that is another something called PBG, or various versions thereof. Now we've also got a choir sound from something called a PPG. Now, another PPG, so this thing here, it's not actually a PPG, it's Apple's sort of equivalent, right, that's not a PPG there. Apple's equivalent sort of variant of that, an attempt to, it even looks a bit like it with the blue there. So that's that. How that's produced. We've got some drums. These are all coming from Ultrabeat or various other drum software. I think there's a Lin Mark II software version here, so I'll bring those in. Right, so what else we got? Now, here, you'll hear this bit here, which is hopefully... Oh, it's muted. You can see my mini loop software playing. I'll just unmute that, bring everything in. Now we hear the brass. Won't have the harpsichord there, anyway. Now, here's the mini Moog coming in shortly. There it is. And then move to this one. We don't have a real mini Moog lying around. We'd like one, but that's not happening at the moment. Now, what else we got? We've got a few other tracks coming in here. We've got a few different percussion sounds. That thing is one of two samples on this track. The rest is completely resynthesized. But like I say, this track isn't necessarily typical of the way we do things. We do refer to various versions of the track as we can. And you'll see from this ridiculously accurate tempo that this is, you know, timed to something that's obviously come from an analog domain at 0.3456 beats per minute. So, you know, coming in at the end here, this tail out part, we have this synthetic choir coming in shortly. And again, that is from Apple's retro synth in PPG mode, coming in shortly. Now, also from this track, you look here, I think it's here, or maybe this track here, you'll see it start to automate. One of these will move around. Or is it? No, no, it does, but it's not at the moment because I've moved the track forward. So you see this one here, we lift it up. It's obviously not quite the right sound because we don't have the original PPG wavetables in there, but purpose of this demonstration, it's good, we'll use the real PPG closer to the time. And now I'll just quickly go back to the bass line. Oh. Anyway, there's the track, thanks for listening.